They came from the four corners of the earth. The mightiest gladiators from Great Britain, Finland, America, and Russia. Together, for the first time in history, united to accept the challenge of the international champion contenders in a battle that would decide who is the best in the world.
We'll move on to the semi-finals. But John, that is just the tip of the iceberg.
Well, that's right, Mike. Tonight's contenders, they are representing their countries. They are the best in their particular countries. And rightly so, if they win and they go through, they will receive the biggest prize we can give them, which is two tickets each to see the world first class. So let's meet tonight's contenders, who are...
From Russia, female competitor Olga Duodnik.
And from Great Britain, Eunice Huthart.
Olga, welcome to Birmingham. Where do you come from? Where is your hometown?
Hi, guys. I'm from Moscow, Russia.
And what do you do for a living?
Track and field athletics, sprinter, 100 meters.
100 meter sprinter. And how do you think you're going to do against the gladiators here in England?
I am happy to take part in the game.
And we're happy to have you here. Best of luck against the gladiators. Use some of that speed to get by them. Olga Duodnik from Russia.
Now, Eunice, here we are, the international gladiators. How many people did you beat to get here?
Well, first we had to compete against 25,000 people at the very beginning. And then it's been whittled down and whittled down, and eventually I've been through four rounds of the gladiators and beat each competitor in each round.
What do you actually do for a living?
For a living, I am actually a full-time kickboxer and a full-time mum when I can.
And is your little one here today? Is it a boy or a girl?
A little girl, Carly. She'll be over there somewhere.
And how do you think you're going to do tonight?
Well, last time I was just representing Liverpool. It's not a just, because Liverpool is 100% I'm a Liverpool girl. But it means a lot more to be representing your country as well.
Well, off you go. Get yourself ready. Wish you all the best.
All right, let's meet tonight's men's competition. First from Finland, Tommi Vuoristo.
And from the USA, Kyler Storm.
Tommi, welcome. Where are you from in Finland?
I'm from Kerava.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a mechanical engineer.
Are you going to use some of the knowledge that you have as a mechanical engineer to apply to the competition against the gladiators? How do you think you're going to do against them?
Well, of course I'm going to use my engineer...
background, qualities, right?
Yes. And I will try to do my best. And let's see how far it takes.
Well, it could take you a long, long way. Tommi, best of luck. He was the 1994 Finnish champion. Tommi Vuoristo.
Now, Kyler, you're a stuntman. Can you tell us some of the stunts which you've done?
Sure. I've done one Labor Day, we had a big block party. And a friend of mine was in on it. He told me to drive. He wanted to drive his car down the road, and he would run me over. I would go over the top of the car, over the back of the trunk, and just land flat on my face. But unfortunately, when he hits me, he threw my feet up in the air, and my butt went into the windshield, and I broke the windshield and got stuck a little bit. But I did manage to still roll over the car, and it played it off really good, and the whole neighborhood just freaked. They thought it was like a real hit and run type of deal. But we just got up and just said, you know, it was just entertainment, and we just something to fool around with, you know.
And where are you actually from in America?
Stockton, California, I call hometown, and it's the Central Valley. And I'm up to see them after the competition. I haven't been there for about 3 years, so it's going to be a great reunion. Hopefully a victorious reunion from this Gladiator International.
Good. We wish you all the best. Get yourself ready, Carl.
All right, you've seen the Gladiators. You've heard from the contenders. Let the games begin. Event number one, women's sky track. In the pink uniform, Russian track and field star Olga Duodnik. Her opponent in the yellow uniform, British kickboxing champion Eunice Huthart. For the Gladiators, joining forces, Great Britain and America, the chase team of Lightning and Jazz. Over to our international referee, Larry Thompson.
Russia, ready!
A straight race over this figure eight course, and what the Gladiators will try to do is hit the detonator that trails both our contenders.
Just like that, Lightning takes Olga out. Now it's all about Eunice and Jazz.
Eunice can sense that finish line, but Jazz closing in, reaches out, and she's got her.
She smokes her just before the finish line. Neither contender's getting any points. The Gladiators doing a good job, Mike.
Could be a long day for our contenders, but there's four more events to come, plus the eliminator. Brand new experience for Olga, Lightning an old hat at this. It took her four tries, however. She reached out once, twice, three times, and finally the fourth time was the charm right there.
And for Eunice, what a disappointment. So close to the finish line, but taken out by Jazz on the last corner.
Now, Jazz, you have Sky Track in America, but I understand it's a little bit different.
Oh, correct. This particular course actually has more curves, and I think this course is much harder than ours.
Is it faster?
I think it's faster, but it's a game where you really have to think. As you can see, I can't just stop and hit the ball. You have to keep moving with it.
Thanks very much, Jazz. Lightning. How did you find that?
Superb. I love this game. Skytrack is one of my favorite events. It's all about power and speed within the legs. You use the hands as balance, especially for turning the corners. But I think I've mastered this game now. I love it. It's really good.
Well, you certainly caught Olga very, very quickly. Let's hear it for Jazz and for Lightning.
Both girls proving how good they are in the air. There's Lightning proving how good she is on the floor.
After one event in the women's competition, Eunice Huthart of Great Britain, 0. Olga Duodnik of Russia, 0. The men are locked in and set to race. Dressed in blue from the United States, Tyler Storm. In the red uniform from Finland, Tommi Vuoristo. For the Gladiators, the chase team of Nitro and Saracen. Over to international referee, Larry Thompson.
Finland, ready! America, ready! Gladiators, ready! 3, 2, 1.
So Nitro's on Tommi Vuoristo and Saracen's behind Kyla Storm.
And the Finn is flying with the lead at the moment, but Tyler catches him in the curve.
And the Gladiators well behind at the moment.
Not an event you want to do on a full stomach. Here they come, headed for the finish line. This one's going to be close. Oh. Who is it?
Well, that has to be a photo finish, Mike. That was too close to call.
Kyler and Tommi side by side. Let's see it one more time. Kyler in the blue. Looks like he just touched out there at the finish to win.
And you can see for yourself, there's the freeze frame. He's the winner.
So after one event in the men's competition, Kyler Storm of the USA 10, Tommi Vuoristo of Finland 5.
Event 2, Powerball.
Eunice Huthart told us earlier what she knows about the other three competing countries.
Russia. They talk funny, they wear fuzzy hats, they stand outside shops in the freezing cold for the dinner. America. They talk funny, very funny. They, there's a lot of fat people there. Eat big meals. Everywhere you go in America, it's like all you can eat for $7. And people just stay there all day. It's amazing. And Finland, don't know much about Finland except they talk funny there. That's about it.
Olga will be using the red balls and Eunice the blue. And guarding those five baskets are our international gladiators, Jazz, Sky, and Panther!
Jazz and Sky from the USA.
Over to Larry Thompson.
Panther Russia from Great Britain.
And Great Britain, are you ready? Gladiators, are you ready?
Better believe it.
Yeah. Eunice said we talk funny.
Well, she is our diplomat from Liverpool.
3, 2, 1.
Let's play ball.
Immediately, Panther ties Eunice up. That time, Jazz doing the honors.
Oh, Olga nearly scored that time.
Eunice gets away to score one.
Olga equalizes there.
Sky riding Eunice out of bounds. Aptly named, it's 6'3" tall. Olga scores again. She takes the lead.
Olga leads Jazz on a merry dance for another two.
Ah, Panther pouncing on Olga. Jazz doing the same to Eunice.
And Eunice didn't come out of that tackle too well. She looks a bit winded to me.
Oh, she breaks away there to score. 10 seconds remain now. Olga still leads, 6-4.
Some great tackling by Jazz. Olga sticks another two in there.
8-4 the final.
And Eunice looks a little out of sorts. Lost her focus on this. Flag day down there, though, Mike.
Olga gave the Gladiators a little lesson in Russian roulette.
And Jazz, great tackling all the way.
Congratulations, Eunice and Olga. How did you find that, Eunice?
It was tough. I just can't seem to get my head together properly. I want to have to go backstage and focus in a minute. Get ready for the rest of the show, because I'm definitely not having a good show so far.
How important is it being 100% focused?
It's very important to me. Just my mind's just not right. I'm just going to go and get it right now.
Okay, Eunice, well, you got yourself 4 points. Olga, how did you find that, and how much did your speed help you?
It's a beautiful game. But there were two competitors I beat easily. But one girl was very strong. But nevertheless, I tried very hard, no matter how difficult the fall was.
I love you. I love you.
Well, congratulations. You got yourself 8 points. Jazz, it looked hard work. How did you find it?
Hard. Very difficult. The girls, they're not to be underestimated. Two good contenders. That's what we want. Good contenders. Brings out the best in us.
Panther, looked like you missed a couple of tackles there. You weren't yourself.
Not today. They were quick. I tried to get there, just couldn't get my arms around them to pull them down, but I had two powerhouses from the States with me today. They were good.
And let's hear it for our international gladiators, Sky, Panther, and Jazz!
Competition, Eunice Huthart of Great Britain, 4, Olga Duodnik of Russia, 8.
Tommi Vuoristo told us earlier how Finnish gladiators compares to this competition.
In Finland, we have about 8 different games. You have 16. So that is a very big difference. And we can practice here in advance, but in Finland, we don't. That's a very, very big difference also.
Tommi from Finland will be using the red balls, and Kyla from the USA will be using the blue. And guarding those baskets is Trojan, Dynamite, and the Terminator!
It's gonna be 10 and a half.
Over to Larry Thompson.
Dynamite from Russia, Terminator from Finland, and of course Trojan representing Great Britain.
Had a serious haircut by the look of it as well.
Gladiators, are you ready?
Tommi talked about the opportunity of having a chance to practice beforehand. Nothing can get you ready for Powerball except just going out there and doing it. Basically, it's all instinct. Tommi has one roll off the cylinder early on.
Eludes Dynamite.
Only for the moment. Dynamite coming back to make the save. There, Tommi scores the first points of the match.
Oh, and Kyla evens it up with a two.
And Tommy's got another one. It's 4-2.
What a dummy there.
Faked like he was going to go in the outside cylinder, and then Kyler scored in the center for three.
Oh, what's that? On the head, Harry. Bit of soccer there, Mike.
In Powerball, just about anything goes.
Some big tackles coming in now.
And it is apparent that both our contenders are running out of gas here.
2 points there, just as you say that, Mike, is not always the way. Kyler on seven, Tommi four. It ends up in the basket.
Gets no points for that.
He's happy with his performance. He's head over heels. Well, Tommi got away with murder. The referee didn't see him outside the zone, and he slipped in those 2 points. In Powerball, you get everything you deserve. Blood, sweat, and tears. There's the blood.
Congratulations. A very clean and fair game. Tommi, apart from your bloody nose, as it was, how did you find it?
I'm not sure which one of them took it from me, but it's okay. That happens. You can't. Nothing about it.
You're obviously very, very fast. You've got a lot of agility. Did that help?
No. In my opinion, I was so slowly. And, well, that was awful.
Any injuries? Did you get injured at all?
No. Maybe that
not. Apart from that?
Yeah, no.
Well done. Well, you got yourself 4 points. Carl, tremendous display. Very fit, very sharp. How did you find it?
Challenging at first. They double teamed the California man. They double teamed me. I couldn't believe it. But first time I got sacked, I was driven.
Tell us,
to the ground.
What does double team you mean?
There's two walls. Both of them. Terminator. What is Dynamite? They were right there in my face. I said, I just have to take this one and go down. I went down after that, started getting the rhythm, and got pumped. Pumped, went for that middle cylinder.
But you got center basket, which I haven't seen done for a long time.
Thank you very much. Tough guys are tough. And
well, you got yourself 7 points.
Well done.
Dynamite, how did you find that?
That game, very explosive. You English crazy, but I love you.
Terminator. How did you find that?
Yeah, I came over here to destroy. That's the name of the game.
Well, there you are. Came over here to destroy. You're certainly doing that. Trojan, what about you? Obviously very popular. How did you find that fitting in with a new team?
It was great. I mean, it's a minute of hard, but very clean, powerful. We've got Dynamite, we've got Terminator, got myself Trojan, communicating. Slap each other, pointing. People knew what was happening. It was good.
Even though you didn't speak any of the same language, you still were able to tell each other where to go?
Yeah, it's just like a tap on the back and a point and communication, eye contact. And we're starting to work as more of a team. I think it's going to be a great show.
Congratulations. Very fair game. Let's hear it for our Gladiators.
I think everyone's fair game tonight, Mike. You guys talk funny and we're just crazy.
Where will it all end?
So after two events in the men's match, Tommi Vuoristo of Finland 9, Kyler Storm of the USA 17.
Well, at the end of Powerball, it's time to have a very short break. But don't go away, because we're going to be back very soon and you can see some more exciting fun on the International Gladiator!
National Indoor Arena in Birmingham, England, with more International Gladiators. And we are set now for event number three, the game of spring and recoil, women's swing shot. We ask you to turn your attentions to the contender tower. In the pink uniform from Russia, Olga Duodnik. And wearing the yellow uniform, 1994 British Gladiator champion Eunice Huthart. Gladiators, she's the limit, Sky. She'll be joined by the electrifying Lightning. Over to our international referee, Larry Thompson.
Great Britain and Russia, are you ready? Gladiators, are you ready?
Swing out sisters. They meet in the middle and a great defensive job by Lightning, leaving Olga empty-handed, but Eunice gets away with a blue for two.
All four athletes tethered to bungee cords. Eunice has got a yellow this time. She's got to put it in the scoring bin to make it count. She had two yellows.
Two yellows.
She now has a total of four. She has picked off another one.
And Olga not having much luck here. As I say that, she picks up her first yellow.
Interesting technique, holding the scoring marker in her mouth.
Or in the beak, as we say.
In the old beak.
Sky, definitely with her head in the clouds, not getting the swing of this at all. Lightning doing great defensive work.
Eunice again, scot-free. She's got two more yellows.
And there's no more yellows left up there, so Olga's gonna have to climb for a blue. Oh, look at this, big preparation. Oh, out of time here. But that's what I mean about pulling the blue. Eunice 8, Olga 1.
Brand new experience for Olga Duodnik, and it showed, but Eunice Huthart, she talked about her lack of focus in the first two events. She certainly had it here in swing shot.
Certainly the bungee helped her bounce back.
In the women's competition, Olga Duodnik of Russia 9, Eunice Huthart of Great Britain 12. The men are atop their platforms, ready for a swing shot in the red uniform from Finland, Tommi Vuoristo. And in the blue from the USA, Kyler Storm. Working against them, the Gladiators, it's Wolf and Nitro.
All the way there.
Over to international referee, Larry Thompson.
Finland and America, are you ready? Gladiators, are you ready?
This ought to be good, John. Nitro and Wolf, the nasty twins, they're so bad they don't even like themselves. They knocked nearly all the balls off the cylinder. Kyler Storm, however, was able to grab not one but three reds, a total of 9 points. What a start for him.
The gruesome twosome certainly got their work cut out for them tonight. And Tommy needs to get up there and pull some points back.
The only problem, John, there's not too many scoring markers left up there.
And there's a few more to hit the floor.
Tommy did get a yellow. He puts it in. He's on the scoreboard.
Oh, look at Wolf and Nitro.
Tommy's got another one. And Kyler's got, let's see how many, three blues, and he's gonna put them all back in to make them count, though.
That's greedy.
He does, 17 points.
That's the highest score I've ever seen in this game.
A
entertainment value very high in that one.
Right side up, upside down, Kyler Storm extremely comfortable in midair. Look at that, he's baiting the Wolfman.
And no wonder, look at this move. Up go his feet, almost upside down, strips away 9 points from the Wolf.
Results after three events in the men's competition. Tommi Vuoristo of Finland, 13. Kyler Storm of the USA, 34.
First up is Olga from Russia, and waiting to run the bridge against Jazz and Flash, Sky and Panther. Over to John Anderson.
Russia, ready! And here goes, ready! Three.
In this event, contenders are given 2 points for every successful crossing of this treacherous suspension bridge, but you have to touch that back railing.
2 points already. And she's dodging the traffic very nicely. I guess being Russian, she's using a larder.
A little like rush hour. Forgot to touch the back railing there. That crossing will not count.
Well noticed. Jazz taking a time on the shot there.
And time expires. Three successful crossings for Olga Duodnik, a total of 6 points.
Here's the incident. Forgets to touch the back bar, as Mike spotted.
Next up to face our gladiators from Great Britain is Eunice Huthart. Over to John Anderson.
Great Britain, ready!
John, I think that focus is back.
I was just going to say that, Mike. She looks like she means business now.
3, 2, 1.
Ducks one. Dodges another. One successful crossing.
Very tentative there as two collided in the middle.
Two giant demolition balls.
Demolition balls from hell.
Like being chased by giant ball bearings or something. This is diabolical.
It's a nightmare out there.
Only this isn't Elm Street, it's a suspension bridge.
Coming up for a fifth successful crossing. That'll get her 10 points.
Liverpool's Eunice Huthart, and pass the word around, the focus is back.
Well done, Eunice. Congratulations. You look a lot more comfortable now. Earlier on, you were a bit down in the dumps, weren't you? How do you feel?
Yeah, just had a word with my coach, Alfie Lewis, got on the phone. He showed me how to focus. I'm focused now, and I want to take this today.
Do you know how many you scored?
10 points.
Well done, Eunice. You got yourself 10 points.
After four events in the women's competition, Olga Duodnik of Russia, 15. Eunice Huthart of Great Britain, 22.
Next up, the men's event. And the first of our contenders from Finland is Tommi. And he's going to be facing Spartak and Trojan. Hawk and Dynamite. Over to John Anderson.
Finland,
old Dynamite's pumped up.
Handsome devil, isn't he?
What's he gonna do when he loses those looks?
Beats me. Here comes Tommi. Oh, one knocks him down, one knocks him up again. He's lucky.
Vuoristo throwing caution to the wind, deciding just to sprint across the suspension bridge.
Oh, that's it. Time up. Lucky matters are over.
Down he goes. The bridge too far.
Oh, look at Dynamite swing his thing. Like a scene out of one of those Russian discos, Saturday Night Fever.
John Revoltovich.
Unlucky, Tommi. You're very, very fast. It looked like you were going for speed there to try and get more points.
Yeah. I'm so far away from Calvin that I have to take the big risks. Well, that wasn't worth it.
Never mind, you still got yourself 4 points. Well done, Tommi, from Finland.
Up next, the USA's Kyler Storm. Here's his thoughts on the International Gladiators.
There will be some slight modifications in their form and their teamwork because they probably haven't done this yet. But they are also, I saw them today, they are very strong and very big looking, and of course they're athletes, they're professionals. They will adjust to what is at hand.
America, ready!
And they'd like nothing better than to knock Kyler's block off.
Why is that then, Mike?
Ready!
Just because they're gladiators.
Three, two, one!
So Kyler looking to storm the bridge.
Tommi Vuoristo was talking about taking risks. This man, a real risk taker.
Seems to be paying off so far. That's two successful crossings.
A little alley shuffle up there. Bobbing and weaving.
Ducking and diving.
Eight.
I don't think a demolition ball has touched him yet. That one does.
Flattened him there. Did he touch the back?
Oh, wow. Man. He just banged his chin on the bottom of the bridge.
That looked like it hurt.
He looks a bit stunned, John.
There's his girlfriend. She looks pretty stunning, too.
Can't comment on that. I have a fiance.
He made some great moves on this bridge.
Oh, he sure did.
Well done, Kyler. It looked like you were looking forward to this event, weren't you?
Oh, yeah. Got a little nip on the chin. Nothing bad. Oh, shoot, what can I say? This is the man here. I finally got back at him. In the USA, he took me out in the gauntlet.
Really?
This time I got it.
Well, he didn't get you this time. No. You were just a couple of seconds away from getting 2 points there. Referee blew his whistle.
Oh, so glad. All right. I'll take it, though, all right?
Well, you did very well. You still got yourself 10 points.
All right, thank you.
Well done.
After four events in the men's match, Tommi Vuoristo of Finland, 17. Kyler Storm of the USA, 44. We are set now for event number five. The women will go at it first in the joust. For the contenders, from Russia, Olga Duodnik. And she'll do battle with Finnish gladiator Flash.
Flash weighing in at 11 stone and standing 5'6" tall.
She should pack a punch with that combat stick.
Olga giving away 2 stone.
Russia, ready!
But a lot of this event has to do with balance, just being able to stay on those sky bikes.
A certain amount of luck as well, Mike. Depending on which way the bike wants to go. It's got a mind of its own up there. And those combat clubs, well, they're not that heavy, but they do take you off balance if you don't swing the right way.
Or overswing. Olga waiting for her chance.
10 points if she gets the job done on Flash. 5 if she stays on.
The Russian fans here at the National Indoor Arena shouting, Olga, Olga. That guy looks like a tic-tac man there.
Yeah. I would like to guess what he's saying. Olga picks up 5 points.
But John, was it worth it? Look at the pounding she takes from Flash. We'll have to hide this videotape.
It's a tough job, but someone's got to do it, Mike.
Next up for the contenders, from Great Britain, the 1994 British Gladiator champion, Eunice Huthart.
Yes, our kickboxing champion, Eunice Huthart. Weighing in at 10 stone, standing 5'7" tall, but that's kind of irrelevant here because she'll be sitting.
She's got the eye of the tiger. She'd like nothing better than to knock Flash off her sky bike.
And pick up that valuable 10 points, Mike.
2, 1.
Once again, 30 seconds, the time limit. And wow, right there.
Ouch.
So far, Eunice holding her own.
Here we go, round again. Watch out for that big one on the back of the head. 2 blows, that really felt them. Eunice just trying to keep her balance up there.
She's defenseless at the moment. One last go around here.
Flash is certainly flush with the hits.
It's a shame we don't award style points. It's a fair bet that Eunice wasn't thinking about those points, however, just surviving.
These are big hits from Flash, like thunderbolts. And Eunice looks to me like she's saying, let's get this over.
After five events in the women's competition, Olga Duodnik of Russia, 20. Eunice Huthart of Great Britain, 27. Contender and Gladiator are mounted on their sky bikes. It's the men's turn to joust. First up for the contenders from Finland, Tommi Vuoristo. And look out, Tommi, as he draws Trojan.
One big fella, 6'2" and 17 stone.
Tommi Vuoristo nearly 6 stone lighter than Trojan. To make matters worse, the mechanical engineer will face a gladiator who handles that combat stick like a broadsword.
And there he is up on his horse. You could say Trojan horse, certainly in his element up there.
3, 2, 1.
Straight to work, that was a big one. And he's over. Wow, he doesn't hang around up there.
All of 2 seconds.
One shot, Tommy gone. And Trojan savoring the moment. And our mechanical engineer is going to have to go back to the drawing board.
Hey, Tommy, I give you credit for just sitting on that sky bike. I wouldn't want to face off against Trojan. How was it up there for you?
Well, that was so short time that I didn't get any touch on that.
Well, was it harder to stay on the bike or harder to withstand the blows that the gladiator was able to give out?
I'm not sure. Was it my fault or did he hit me so hard? I'm not sure.
Probably a little bit of both.
Maybe that.
The big important thing, you survived. Tommi Vuoristo, Finland. Nice work, Trojan.
Nice work indeed, if you can get it. Lucky Trojan isn't paid by the second, otherwise he wouldn't have earned much for that fight.
Next up, hoping to sit tight in his sky bike, from the USA, Kyler Storm.
Kyler Storm. Same height as Trojan, giving away 3 stone. And look at that, a motivational
America,
speaker.
Ready!
But this is no time for words. This is time for action.
Ready!
There's the action man.
3, 2, 1.
Both men wailing away at each other with those combat sticks.
And let's face it. Kyler Storm not got complete control of this horse.
He doesn't have complete control of anything.
He's all over the place.
He's hanging on for dear life.
He thinks he's John Wayne up there.
I know, well, big windup.
Oh, jippy, aye, aye. Take that.
And
good night.
Down he goes.
Oh, get off your horse and drink your milk.
Just got a little too fancy for his own good up there.
Bit of a cowboy.
Listen up, with just 1/2 a second left on the clock, Trojan got the victory and denied Kyler Storm a chance for 10 points. Kyler, there's no, just 1/2 a second and no question in anybody's mind that the effort was there on your part.
Oh, come on, let's check a replay. Was my, at least my foot still on the pedestal.
John Anderson and referee Larry Thompson right on top of it, 1/2 second left. It was a great battle though.
Well, thank you, and my world has been rocked by Britain. Guy hits hard, man, here we go.
Well, yeah, give him a hand. I'm gonna get out of this one. Trojan, you're outstanding, my man. Did you realize, I know victory is important for the gladiators and your reputation. Did you know how close you were?
Yeah, I mean, the guy was staying on, the first guy was a lot tougher. He was staying on. I was thinking, it's gonna be soon. And, how close was it?
1/2 second.
1/2 second. That's unlucky. It was good timing.
But good timing indeed.
It was lucky.
Good timing, luck, and talent. Trojan! At the end of 5 events, Tommi Vuoristo of Finland, 17. Kyler Storm of the USA, 44. In a moment, the eliminator will decide which which of our contenders moves on to the semifinals. We'll have the run for it all next on International Gladiators. Welcome back, and once again, our competition comes down to the final event, the Eliminator. A berth in the semifinals hanging in the balance. At the moment, Great Britain's Eunice Huthart has a 7-point lead on Russia's Olga Duodnik. That gives the champion kickboxer a 3.5-second head start going into the Eliminator. Over to referee John Anderson.
It's quite incredible because Eunice, at the front of the show, had lost heart. She's refocused herself. And over the next few moments, we're going to see just how sharp her focus is for this Eliminator.
3, 2, 1.
Eunice better be careful because Olga has come from behind potential. A member of the Russian track team where she's a nationally ranked sprinter in the 100 meters.
Well, it doesn't seem to be worrying Eunice. She's already on the hand ladder.
Olga trying to power her way up the rope. Eunice across the rolling beam and now on the cargo net.
And she looks pretty focused to me.
Rock solid, I'd say. Ready to attack the zip line.
And don't forget a place in the semifinals.
Olga trying her best to catch up, but Eunice just too sharp. Now across the balance beam.
Eunice Huthart, the Liverpool housewife. Did she ever dream the dream? Grabs the rope for a place in the semifinals.
Eunice certainly had plenty of support and rushes Olga Duodnik, making short work of the balance beam. Bracing herself for the travel later. No problem with that track and field background. The young Russian did herself proud.
Congratulations, Eunice. You feel a lot better now, don't you?
John, there's one comment my trainer, Alfie Lewis, always says. The sign of a true champion is a champion who can perform when he's up there and perform when he's down there. And that's what I've done today. I perform when I'm down there. It won't happen again, but I still come through.
Congratulations, another winner on our International Gladiator!
Olga, your impressions, the Eliminator the whole day here in Birmingham.
You know, it's a very beautiful game. But I think we need more experience. I think in Russia we're going to build the same marvelous buildings. We'll practice. And we'll win.
Eunice, she was tough, wasn't she?
Yeah, she was tough. But Britain still come through and won.
Eunice Huthart and Olga Duodnik, two great contenders. Congratulations.
Before the men's event, we're going to have a timeout.
The British show is very different from ours. It's, I would have to say, start off with the fans. The fans are large in volume. We have nothing to compare to as far as the fans. It seems that a lot of your events and shows are more advanced than ours. If I didn't know any better, I would think that it started here in Britain and not in America.
They're very much the same. The only difference would have to be some of your games are different than ours, and you guys have some games like that darn pole axe, which we all love so well. If I never have to get up on that thing again, it'll be too soon.
We have more events here than we do. We've done like 7-8 different events. Back in Finland, we are changing one event every year. So here we are doing 16 different kinds. So there's many new events for us to learn.
What's a little bit different is when I used to come out, they used to scream ice, ice, baby. I walk out here, now it's jet, jet, baby.
In a moment, the Eliminator will decide which of these two men, Tommi Vuoristo of Finland or Kyler Storm of the USA, will go on to the semifinals. At the moment, Kyler has a 27-point lead. That is good for a 13.5-second head start. It's a huge advantage, but crazier things have happened in the Eliminator. Question I want to know about, Kyler, how's the chin? You look like you received stitches following the joust. Will that be a factor here in the Eliminator?
No, actually, it didn't even hurt when I smacked on the hit and run is what I did it on. It was that last few seconds, I tried to dive for that last touch, and I dove a little too early, it looked like, and I caught my chin, but didn't feel it, you know, but there are stitches, but it's no problem for the eliminator.
Okay, stay focused, good luck. Tommi, I know as the Finnish champion, you have never been in this position before. Where are you going to drive your sense that maybe something special could happen for you?
Yeah, well, I can promise you that I'm going to go as fast that I can ever go. Well, soon we will see, is it enough?
Tommi, we know you will, and there's a lot of people here at the National Indoor Arena pulling for you. Tommi Vuoristo, Kyler Storm, set to go. One man goes on to the semifinals.
Kyler's girlfriend, Michelle, can hardly bear to watch this. 13 and a half seconds, surely Kyler has to go all the way.
You will go on my whistle. Finland, you will go on John's whistle. 3, 2, 1.
Up and over the high and low hurdles goes Kyler Storm. And that, what is he doing?
Oh, that didn't go right, did it? That'll teach him for being a flash Herbert.
This may be the break that Tommi Vuoristo needs. What was Kyler Storm thinking about?
I guess he thought he had 13 and a half seconds and he could do what he likes.
Better be careful because Tommi has cut into that head start, working his way across the hand bike and now the rolling beam. He has closed the gap.
And it just goes to show, Mike, on the eliminator, don't take any lead for granted.
Never. Michelle rooting him on.
I think she's going to have a few words with him about that incident, don't you?
And look at Kyler trying to keep his balance on that balance beam. He did, but just barely. Now up the travelator he goes. It wasn't pretty, but he has done it, and he puts a little exclamation point on at the end.
And Tommi Vuoristo has put so much effort into catching up Kyler that he's pooped out before he hits the travelator. Deep breath, head high. And this man wants to get to the top. And he does it. And we're glad to see him come through. Tremendous contender.
Congratulations. You made it hard work for yourself there. What were you actually trying to do there on the rope?
Well, actually, I asked the referee during practice if he could use the ledge, climb up, and then grab the rope to pull up. So I started using the ledge. And then Larry said, use the rope. I was about to. Lost my concentration. So I just grabbed it in the old-fashioned way. Went ahead and started from there, so.
And even when you came off the last rope before you came through the barrier, the lovely little backspin.
Oh, I love to do that, man. I used to go rope swinging. We would get 30 feet in the air and you twist. And, oh, I just love it.
Well, congratulations.
Well, thank you very much.
Another winner.
Yay!
On the Gladiators, the International.
True to your word, you were pumped up. You made it very, very exciting there at the end, and a lot of people loved the performance here.
Thank you very much. There are so many fans out there that I couldn't let them out.
How does that make you feel when you hear people like this so much behind you?
Well, it gives me more power to go on.
Memorable performance. You didn't win it, but we'll remember you here at the National Indoor Arena. Suomi, Finland, kiitos. Thank you.
Thank you. And I want to say best regards to my girlfriend, baby.
Who is back in Finland?
Yeah, I miss him.
Okay, congratulations. Tommi Vuoristo. So that's our story from the National Indoor Arena in Birmingham, England, as two more contenders advance to the semifinals. For John Fashionew and all of us, I'm Mike Adamley. Glad you could join us. See you again on International Gladiators.
For safety reasons, do not attempt to recreate any of the events you have seen on Gladiators.
Jim and Tommi return for more darts and a bit of a pub quiz in Bullseye next here on Challenge. And tonight at 9, the Chaser proves they're not here to make friends, but Bradus is always by your side in the chase.